The shadow. The shadow. So what's the dung spreader doing today? Well, the dung spreader is combining peas. This is the field where we did the sunset soliloquy and the rolling, rolling, rolling video. It was about right here, actually. Well, there's peas here and there's barley there. And the reason is I ran out of barley seed and I did have a few pea seeds left. A few bags of pea seeds, so I used them up in here. It went in late. I didn't think we'd get anything, but we did. But this field is very wet. You can see a lot of bare patches out there. And that's because of the damp and also the animals. You can see the trails where the animals have been running through here. You have to excuse me, I have to keep looking at the table. The animals have been having a great time crisscrossing through here. They don't really eat peas much, but it's on their main route to some better stuff, which happened to be my wheat, which was up there. And they made a mess of that wheat field. I think they had about 10 to 15% of my whole crop in there. You see the green patch? That's quack grass. That's the eternal enemy. But if you look down, you'll see a pickup reel. Well, not a pickup reel, a bat reel. And a direct cut header from our auger transfers the crop to the center of the combine where those fingers pick it up and flick it back into the feeder house or conveyor, depending on which part of the world you come from. So, I have to admit this is the first time I've ever grown peas for combining. And people tell me all kind of horror stories. And actually, it's not too bad. This field hasn't yielded well, but the field I did previous to this, I had what I consider a reasonable crop out of that. I estimated at about 50 bushels to the acre, which I don't think is too bad on organic land. I mean, the only other feedback I've had is is from a grain farmer who uses seed and sprays and fertilizer, and he got 80 bushels to the acre, which I think is outstanding. And he's been at it a lot longer than I have, and so I think 50 bushels to the acre is it's pretty damn good. I think this field is going to be possibly around 30, but you know, if you look at it, it is very bare. And I don't have the ideal equipment for this. I've got a rigid header and a flex header would probably be better. It would follow the contours of the ground better and it would pick up the low lying pea plants. I'm not doing too bad. If you look down there, I'm not missing too much, I don't think. So less than ideal equipment, but this is all I could find that was in our price range. Like I said, a very good friend of mine let me have it at a reasonable price, and I'm very grateful. It means that we can oops, got a bit of a blockage there. It means you have to go backwards, let her suck in the blockage, and then forward again. Obviously, the problem with peas is you drag a bit of dirt up every time you do that. So that flex setter would be better. It would follow the contours of the ground. It wouldn't pick up dirt on a high spot. Just got another blockage happening over there. If I can get rid of it just by backing up.
Yeah,
there she goes. Not too bad, not too much soil in there. Just get her going again. This combine is hydrostatic drive. Everything is controlled from this lever here, forwards and backwards. And header up, header down, reel up, reel down. Very, very handy to operate. You have to excuse me. I'm trying to film and trying to look at everything at the same time. And a little bit of thistle there. Thistle's great stuff. It actually holds the peas up, makes them easier to combine. No, I'm joking. It does do that, but thistle is another enemy along with cartgrass. You really do not want it in your fields. Have to excuse me again. I got a bit of a sore throat this morning. Might be getting a cold. Lots of people around here have got colds, but anyway, let's hope not. Let's hope it's just a bit of dust from the peas. There we are. We've finished the row. If you look over there, you can see the rest of the field and see my barley. It's still not particularly well mature, but you know, you do what you can in this part of the world. Just turning around, there's about 27 acres here. It's just what I planted with the seed I had left. Not spectacular, I know, but this is a wet field. And you can see a wet patch right there, and there's another one over there. I came in here last night in the dark, and I'll turn that noisy header off. I couldn't see where the hell I was going, and I ended up in a wet patch, and I damn nearly sank out of sight. I had to slam her in reverse and shoot out of there backwards. And then you've got to find your way around it in the dark, and you don't quite know how big it is. You think you know where you are in the field. You're trying to remember from the spring, but you don't know which direction to go. And oh God, what a performance. But anyway, we managed to get around. I've been three times around, once up and down here, and I'm going to work the field up and down now, because that's the way it was plowed and that's the way it was drilled. So that's going to be the flattest way. Lots of people around here just go round and round and round, which is not the right way to do it, because your field is not flat if you go round and round. The other way to get your fields flat and keep them flat is to work up and down. So that's what I'm going to be doing. You can see the autumn colors on the trees. The leaves have pretty much gone. Strong winds the last few days took them away. We're in late September now. Pretty soon it'll be October. We've got snow forecast in a couple of days' time. I've still got a lot to do. I've got about 420 acres of barley to combine after I've done this. Peas. I've got another pea field, but the quackgrass is so bad that it's going to be a real problem combining it, and I'm leaving that because I know it's going to take a long time. And if we don't manage to get it and we have a lot of snow and the snow demolishes it, well, I'm just going to disc it in and use it for green manure for next year. Well, actually next year I'll be summer fallowing the field, because the quackgrass is so bad, I'm going to have to kill that quackgrass before I can plant another crop in there. So anyway, here we are, early fall, northern Canada. Combining peas. These peas are as hard as bullets. And if you can remember when you were a kid and you had a pea shooter, well, that's the kind of peas they are. It's organic, so it's going to go into organic animal feed. And it'll supply protein in an organic animal feed mix. I'm also going to be keeping a bag or two, and I'll be soaking them and making mushy peas. Fish, chips and mushy peas. Pie, mushy peas and gravy. What more could you ask for? Champion, oh, you're the champion. So there we are. Better get on, get some bloody work done. Take care of yourselves, look after one another. And I'll be talking to you next time. Bye for now.